Today I'm going to show you how I make Asian Zing quail. First, start with some quail. I have four quail here and they're butterflied out. That's how I clean them, cut them right up the back. Go ahead and put them on a plate and then go ahead and get some seasoning. I use this all-purpose seasoning. It's simply salt, garlic salt, and some oregano and rosemary. And go ahead and just sprinkle them all over the outside here. Kind of get them all nice and happy. One of the things I do recommend is I think quail really does well with a decent amount of salt, but of course, just taste it however you want. If you have poultry seasoning, anything like that in the fridge or in the pantry, go ahead and use it. Whatever you normally use to season chicken will work out just fine. Make sure you get both sides. And then all I do is take a little bit of cornstarch here and I just kind of sprinkle it over. The amount's not really important. You don't really need to coat them like you would if you were going to deep fry something. All this is going to do is help give us a nice crispy crunch on the outside. I do skin my quail so they don't have any skin on it, and this really helps give that crisp crunch. Go ahead and just kind of pat it down. You could also do this inside of a Ziploc bag if you wanted to and kind of shake it around, but I find it just as easy to make a mess and do it on the plate. And then you have to let them rest for a minute. That's very important. And then go ahead and turn on the stove to high. Get yourself a cast iron skillet. Yes, I think it tastes better in a cast iron skillet. This one's been in my family for three generations. Yes, it's a Wagner. And no, it's not for sale. Then we need butter. Yes, oil and butter. This amount should work. Don't be shy with the butter. Listen to the sizzle. It's amazing how much food brings back memories. I remember watching my mom stand at the stove and do this with the butter. I know you don't really need to do it, but she always did it, so I still do it. Once you get good and hot, go ahead and put the quail in. And I like to put them breast side down. I'm kind of giving them just a little bit of a squish here so they get as much contact with the pan as possible. Go ahead and get all four of them in there. I have this pan currently on about medium high. Obviously, your stove may vary. You're just looking to have that, listen to that sizzle. You're just looking to have that butter kind of sizzle and crackle. Now, here's the hard part. You have to leave them. Don't touch them. Usually for about 4 to 5 minutes. And then after 4 to 5 minutes, give them a turn over. Look at that outside crust. It looks amazing. It looks gorgeous. It's crispy, golden brown, all that flavor of the seasoning. I don't know why this one fought with me. You know, every family has one. And if you don't know who it is, you might be the one. Then once you get them flipped over, you know, it's going to depend on how thick your quail are and stuff. Usually about another 4 to 6 minutes. I do turn the heat down just a little bit. And just kind of keep an eye on them. It's very important with quail that you don't overcook them or they will get dry and they will get tough really quickly. Then I just take some of this sweet chili sauce. It's available at all the grocery stores. If you've never used it, it's amazing. The brand doesn't really matter. And then I just sprinkle it on top. And then I'm just going to let this sit here for probably another 2 minutes or so. All I'm really trying to do is to kind of get this sauce to kind of get tacky and gooey and everything get happy. After you let them rest for a few minutes, that's pretty much going to be it, except for your sides. Tonight, I had it with mashed potatoes, but let me tell you, if you like cheesy grits, pair these up with cheesy grits. They are absolutely amazing. Tender, juicy, deliciousness.